plastics engineering technology is more or less the effort to manufacture plastics materials into a saleable product. We emphasize the process technology, product design, tooling design, and qualification of the end product.
Plastics engineering is taking these polymer chains, which can be in the form of a pellet. You put it into a machine, it can be either injection molding, a blow molder, put it under high amounts of pressure, and then you come out with a product.
We learn the theory behind plastics processing and manufacturing that is used in the real world, from anything from garbage cans to pop bottles. We work with it all.
A lot of people, when they think of plastics, you know, they think cups, you know, maybe your television set, the outside's plastic, cars, you know. But literally, if you sit down and look, you know, everything around you a lot of times is all made of plastic.
When you look at a plastic component or part, somebody had to come up with that idea. Somebody had to actually design the component itself to be functional. Somebody had to select the material it was going to be made out of. And then it has to be manufactured. You have to scale it up for production. And so the people that do all these things, they're all labeled plastics engineers or engineers and technologists. And at Ferris here, we train students to hold those positions.
During the course of a semester, students are exposed to many of the practical aspects of the industry. They're asked to operate various pieces of equipment, machinery.
One of the things we do, which is most important to our program, is we get inside of a lab just like this, and we process the materials and we make these products, you know, firsthand with the machines, you know, up close and impersonal, and really get an intimate understanding of how those things work.
Plastics engineering is definitely more hands-on learning. We do a lot with the different machines, changing molds ourselves, setting up the raw materials, dryers, and running tests on them.
We have equipment that represents most of the major conversion processes in the plastics industry. We have injection molding machines, a broad variety. We have thermoforming machines. We have blow molding machines. We have extruders. And we also have a whole battery of test equipment so that we can evaluate the performance of both the material and the end product.
Mainly what we use is the injection molders, because in Michigan, that's really where most of the business is. Injection molding is huge. So students normally learn a lot more on the injection molding basis rather than anything else.
It's just nice to know that, seeing all these machines out there, that's exactly what we're going to be running in industry, and it's just hit the ground running because we have the equipment available to us to use that is used so widely in industry.
Because we get in the lab, we work these machines, you know, we learn these materials, and we don't just read about them in theory in a textbook. It gives us an advantage.
Pretty much all of our classes have a hands-on portion associated with it, and partly because, well, it's Ferris, and Ferris, one of the founding precepts was learn by doing.
We have to do two internships. The first one is usually just experience, doing different processes and seeing what's out there, and then the second one is to actually make an impact on the company.
Ideally, in fact, probably about 50% of our students, when they go to that second internship, that company will offer them a full-time position when they graduate. So it's really beneficial to do the internships.
Right now, our job ratio for this particular year is 6-1. So for every 6 jobs, we only have 1 graduate. So that's really great right now.
The opportunities at the other end of the rainbow, as I call it, when the students graduate, are remarkable. Last year, in this department, we had 160 companies contact us looking for our graduates. So there's many opportunities for employment after you graduate. And that's a really important aspect of education that many universities don't stress.
The student-faculty relationships are really good. Small class sizes, which is a huge benefit because we get to know our professors really well.
All the professors know you by name. They know pretty much what's going on in your life.
It's a strong relationship between the students and the faculty, and we actually know how they perform and try to help them with their weaknesses as they progress through the program.
If you don't understand something or you want more clarification or just more information in general, they really are genuinely passionate about what they're talking about, what they're teaching.
The favorite aspect of this program, for me anyway, is definitely the people. The people here are phenomenal.
I love the hands-on. I love all of our labs. We have a testing lab, a decorating and assembly lab, and several different processing labs.
It's really interesting. We get all these new technologies, new materials, all these exciting things, you know, so you're never really bored with the industry.
I like the fact that that I'm around younger people. It tends to make me feel younger and keeps me from aging quite so quickly.
If anybody's interested in pursuing a degree in plastics engineering technology, they certainly can access the Ferris State website at www.ferris.edu/plastics.